Now we are going to talk about the types of boundary conditions for different situations of heat equation, but these boundary conditions will be equally applied on the wave equation as well. We will see that the situation for the boundary conditions in the form of temperature is applicable on heat equation, and in the wave equation it is applicable in some other form. So there are three types of boundary conditions. So in first type, the temperature is specified on the boundary, which means that U0 of T and UL of T is G of T and G2 of T. The temperature is the function of time, or it can be taken as constant. So temperature can be changing at the boundary, temperature can be fixed at the boundary, but in type 1 boundary condition that boundary temperature is given. Of course, the simplest case is when the temperature is fixed on the boundary, it is not changing. So we are going to solve the equations in which the temperature is fixed on the boundary, but this is the temperature, because in type 2 boundary condition temperature was given, temperature of the boundaries was given. In type 2 boundary condition, the rate of change or the flux of temperature is given. Which means that the temperature is given in the form of derivative. This n is the normal derivative. This means that the temperature is flowing in the in one direction only, x direction. So the temperature flux, that at which rate the temperature is flowing through the end of the rod. In that boundary condition, the simple case is if there is no temperature flow from the end. In that case, so type 2 boundary condition has a special case if there is no flow at the ends. I am not saying that there is zero temperature at the ends. I am saying there is no flow. which means that if we say there is no flow, physically it is possible if we insulate the ends as well. So if there is no flow at the ends, it is also called insulated ends. In that case, the boundary conditions in the form of this. And this makes this equation linear. Sorry, homogeneous. This makes this equation homogeneous. If there is some number here, the equation becomes non-homogeneous. The boundary condition becomes non-homogeneous. So, for the type, second type of boundary conditions where the flux of the temperature is given, a special case is if there is no flow at the end, we can do it physically by insulating the ends. And in that case, we write the boundary condition like this. Derivative is equal to zero. If I remove this derivative, then this becomes the type 1 boundary condition with 0 degree centigrade at both ends. But in that case, if we have a derivative here, it means that there is no flow of heat at the ends. So this is type 2 boundary condition. Then we have type 3 boundary conditions, which we are not going to solve in this course. But in type 3 boundary condition, the temperature of surrounding is given, which is little complicated to solve because it has some other kind of equation, but we are not going to discuss it here now. So this is type 3 boundary condition. So we have type 1BC, which we call Dirichlet boundary condition. We have type 2BC, which is also called Neumann boundary conditions. We have type 3 boundary conditions, which are called Robin conditions, Robin boundary condition. And we have type 4 boundary condition called as mixed boundary conditions. If we have fixed temperature at one end and the flow of temperature at the other end, then it is the mixture of Dirichlet type and Neumann type boundary condition. So the type 4 is called as mixed boundary conditions, which is another complex case to solve. In our course, we are going to solve heat equation using type 1 boundary condition, that is Dirichlet boundary conditions, and type 2 boundary conditions, that is Neumann boundary conditions. We are not going to solve through Robin conditions or mixed boundary conditions.